Hi everybody, here's another video using the Button Buddy stamp set from Stampin' Up. And I'm going to be using this flower. This is the card that we're working on using the Pocket Full of Posies paper. And we're going to cut it up in some strips. So I'm going to show you how to cut these up real quick. And I started with a 5.5 inch by 1 3/4 inch piece of designer paper. And just cut it at varying lengths. I'm going to cut the first piece at 2 inches. And then the next one at 1 inch, as long as they're different sizes. I'm gonna flip this over and put those next to each other. And this one maybe will go to 2 inches, make it a little bit longer. And then the last one will just be whatever's left over. Then I'm just gonna run my glue down this piece of white. The white is just a little bit larger, so don't put the glue right to the edges because I want to have a little bit of that white showing. So we're just gonna take it right to the edge, put it right in the middle, and then build my strip. I have an espresso card. Might be kind of hard to see in my black background, but I also have this little strip of pear pizzazz with the dotted scallop ribbon border, and I'm gonna cut it in half so I don't have to punch it 2 times and glue it behind this little strip right here. So I have some glue back here. I'm just gonna put it right here to the edge and do the same thing for the top. All right, now this little strip will just go down here at the bottom. And then I'm just gonna emboss my greeting. I'm gonna use white craft ink. And I'm gonna use the greeting from my friend. Light little kisses, because it's that craft gushy pad. And right up here in the corner. And then I'm gonna use white embossing powder and then heat it. Okay, I have my ingredient embossed with white embossing powder, and I ran one of these two tags, these bigs from the Sizzix two tags, and the end of it's missing, but it doesn't matter because I'm gonna glue it on here. So I'm gonna take that tag and I'm gonna glue it right about here. And then before I glue the whole thing down, I'm going to slip a little piece of this pear seam binding right underneath here so I can tie that on. Just keeping it right on the roll so I can figure out how much I need here. So just make a little tie and then we'll trim off the rest of the tag. Okay, I've got a little scrap of Whisper White. I'm going to ink up this flower stamp in the navy. And then not quite navy. And you just want to make sure that you stamp it low enough because this will punch out with your scallop punch. But you know, you have to kind of fiddle with it and see where it lines up the best. So if you stamp close to the edge, then you can get it. There it is. And once you find it, just press down a little bit so it holds the paper and then punch it out. So I have my flower, I have dimensionals, and I added a few leaves from the blossoms punch, and I ran it through the lattice folder just for a little extra texture. Got some dimensionals on here, and we're just gonna stick it on. And then I'm gonna bring in my crystal effects to put my buttons on, because I wanna make sure it holds. You wanna put just a little bit of that. Here's a little razzleberry button. And just to dress it up more, I'm taking one of these little vintage antique buttons that we have. And then I'll just come in here with my scissors and snip those off. They come off pretty easy. And then I'm going to use some glue dots under there, and I'm going to attach it to the button, right, just like that. And then on the inside, I just added a greeting and a little bit smaller strip of that designer paper to the inside just to carry it through. So that's it. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.